In this video, I'll show you some of the new features introduced in Crossword Compiler 11.4 over the last year, since about 11.3. So firstly, there has been an extension to the keywords feature and the positioning of extra letters. So keywords are sort of solution words where you highlight extra letters in the grid. So for example, in this grid here, let's say I wanted to have test as being a keyword as a solution. So I could select T, E, S, T. And there is now a new option here to number these squares. And you can choose to number them by the top right or the bottom right. So I select bottom right here. Then I have this keyword where the letters are numbered. The advantage of the numbers is if they aren't in order, this now allows you the freedom to also have them in different orders. We've also added a crossword solver available for everyone on the desktop, which means you can test solve easily. So if you go to File menu, if you've installed the solver, you can then use Test Solve. So here you can see the same puzzle opened in the solver program with the words circled. So if now I enter the letter T in here, it will appear in the solution grid underneath, and E likewise. You can also add additional top right numbers anywhere you like by selecting square properties. So for example, on this N here, if I wanted to have top right or bottom right text, I could put B here as some special extra solution, and B will appear in the grid, which appears in the puzzle, but not in the solution. The Crossword Solver program is available freely and is cross-platform at crosswordsolver.info. So if you go to this website, you can download it, or any of your users can download it, to download your puzzles and solve them offline, supporting a various of formats, including Windows or macOS and Linux support. In this version, the solving applet has also been updated to be fully responsive. So now on smaller screens, if you have a layout that looks like this, as the screen becomes smaller, the clues will hide and you will automatically see this smaller, more compact version that looks like this. There have also been extensive improvements to the word search generator, which now has a much more powerful algorithm that can fit many more words into a grid and fit hidden words in the extra letters. If I have multiple puzzles that I generate with different characteristics, there's now also an option here to view the fill with the most words, most letters, most intersections, or fewest unused squares. There are new options about the number of words that are linked. So for example, this was a puzzle where word links were allowed. You can either insist that the words are all linked to each other or there are no links. If you generate a no links puzzle, then you can get grids that look like this, where there are no overlaps between the words. You get very dense, compact fills. With the professional grid filler, there's a fill options button here where you can fine-tune exactly which kind of fill algorithms are used for a standard word search fill or when you're trying to fit a hidden word. The option to view multiple fills also applies to vocabulary puzzles. If I've generated a bunch of fills using the Create Vocabulary Puzzle feature, I can select this drop down here to see the one with the most words or the one with most letters, which will typically have more of the longer words included in the grid. There have been extensive changes to support adding clues more easily to clues in squares puzzles or arrow words or puzzle pointers where there are clues in the grid with arrows pointing to the different words. If you have clue squares that don't have arrows yet, you can also automatically assign certain arrows by selecting Grid, Add Clue Square Arrows, and it will then automatically add a subset of arrows where it's obvious where they should go. So here it's now added extra arrows to these squares here. Once all the clue squares have arrows pointing to the corresponding words, you can now generate clues and insert them into the grid in the corresponding squares. So if you want to do that using AI to generate the clues, you can go to the clue generator. You can select a clue style, the clue language, and then click generate. It will then generate clues for all of the words for which there's an arrow from a clue square. If there's any missing, you can click redo to regenerate specific clues. Once you're happy with it, you can click use clues. And they will then be automatically fit into the grid with the corresponding clues pointing to the corresponding words. You can do the same thing by adding clues from a clue database, use clues from database. In this version, you've got also an option to specify whether clues are added for across and down words, or only across, or only in down. If I select the American word list here and do all of them, I can now filter the clues by some maximum length, because for a clues and squares puzzle, you don't want very long clues. And you can choose a language for using for hyphenation for wrapping words. If you select OK, then it will select all the words that you have in your database into the grid. Where there are missing clues, you'll end up with blank spaces, and those will need to be either generated using AI, using the clue generator. If I go back here, you'll see the list of ones that were not in the database, and I can generate just those and insert those automatically. The Clue Square editor also has a generate button where you can view automatically a selection of possible alternative clues for a given word. In some parts of Europe, clues in squares puzzles often don't have arrows actually showing, so there's actually an option now to add, in Add Clue Square Arrows, to add hidden arrows, which means that they're only used for linking squares to words. They don't actually appear in the solution grid. So you can also add hidden arrows and then generate clues without affecting the number of arrows that actually appear in the grid. For export, there are a number of new options, including under page setup, you can choose exact size used for PDF export. And you can also choose landscape or customize the size as you like. The help assistant has been significantly updated, so you can ask questions and it will have automatic access to the entire help and web content, so it can answer your question specifically. So if you want to ask, how do I insert an image? The AI assistant will use its knowledge of the help database to tell you the different ways of inserting an image, either pasting an image or inserting an image file, or putting in background image in square properties. There are many other minor features. For example, you can now redo and undo changes in the grid easily. It's also easier to edit pictures in the grid. If you wanted to have a look at this image here, you could right-click on it to bring up the image properties. You can export the image, but you can also replace the image file directly, or you can drag and drop the image here and it will just replace it in the grid with the same settings. For Sudoku puzzles, there is a new option to generate lots of them at once. So on the generate here, instead of generating a single puzzle by clicking generate, I could click save multiple fills. Then you can select a folder to save things to. They'll be saved with this template name, and you can specify the number of fills. So this would generate 10 fills numbered from 1 to 10. Click OK, and it will generate the 10 puzzles for you and save them. If you want to export them, you could use export multiple files. Then you could open whichever subset of these files and then bulk export them. Likewise, if you wanted to generate puzzles for the web, you could use web export convert files to Applet files to generate a set of Applet files immediately from your generated set of Sudokus. There are many other small improvements that have taken place during the year, but that's it for this recording. Enjoy the programme.